We find ourselves on the edge of space in a ship laden with resources white and purple. Compound and resin make up our armaments as we set forth to land back on the planet Tundra. I've come fresh from Terran, home of all these bountiful basic resources, the likes of which I have so far been unable to pin down on this planet of want, empty cold, desolation. Maybe I should not have called this planet home, but I'm going to try and give it another chance and see if we can't find anything worthwhile here, perhaps diving down into some caves. But first, where am I running? I'm absentmindedly just heading back home, forgetting that I need to start carrying some of these trays of goodies with me. Let's first take that which has both resin and compound. A little bit of both. It's gonna take a while to kind of run carrying this heavy cart. We don't have any vehicles that can assist us just yet, but that is why I have fetched all of these goodies so that I can go back, build up a whole bunch of platforms for us, and the compound is gonna be good for getting us the basics. I've already made a smelter, but we do need a research terminal and a handful of other locations, and that's why I've got like 15 resin. We're making a bit of a Y formation sprouting out from each side. I'll show you exactly what I mean if I can find a location for this new tray. I'm gonna go ahead and put the lithium on the side next to some copper here to free up the space for the storage container on this location. Now, as we move back here, I'm gonna kinda trade some of the resources in my pack for some of those on the shelf here. For example, let's pick off two resin. And in those empty spaces, you'll notice that I have filled up my backpack with even more compound and even a handful of aluminum that I was able to pin down. That's gonna be good for getting us, once smelted of course, another truck, which we can then add a crane and a drill. It's happening today, I guarantee it. Shift click the resin to bring it back in, and now we start with the Y's. So I'm gonna angle a little bit off to the side. It does not have to be rocket science or anything like that. Gonna left click and create another hub platform and do one on the opposite side as well. So these are gonna be almost kissing, the ones that I just created next to the smelter here, which is not getting any power for some reason. You guys see the sun is up, right? And you see that I have a solar panel, right? Something is strange, something is off. Let's try taking the resources off of the edge of the habitat here. Kind of peering around to see what might be the problem. The smelter absolutely should be getting some power from the wind turbines, if nothing else. I don't think the lack of battery has anything to do with it. You can't pin the solar panel on the side of the habitat, which is what I was going to attempt to do. This is indeed strange and unprecedented. Is one of my tubes off? I don't know. Let's ignore it for now and try to create some more platforms and see what we can come up with. I'm gonna need two more units of resin here if my backpack was not full. So let's put the lithium down and perhaps one of the aluminum. Take two more resin. We're gonna have to go back to the ship here sooner or later and turn this into another platform. I didn't expect it to be even parallel with this one, but hey, it looks kind of nice, even though they're not quite the same distance across. And we can do copper for a printer. I'm thinking research is gonna come next after, of course, a vehicle bay. Probably the most important thing for us to be able to traverse on this planet. So I got one aluminum already, check. And a second one should be hiding somewhere on one of these platforms. There's copper, and there's the aluminum, awesome. Gonna need even more than this smelted, of course, if I actually to make a vehicle. I'm curious, once this is hooked up, if it's going to receive any power for us. It is. So the grid is working, it's just not working for the smelter. Here's the deal. We may not be able to smelt just yet, but compound is all that is necessary for a rover. So I'm gonna put what we have here and go ahead and create this, because without this rover, I'm gonna have to tether everywhere. And the more tethers you use, the more your game starts to lag, at least until they patch it. And they do have a beta patch that has apparently reduced that lag. However, I cannot use it as of yet because there is always the off chance that switching to the beta branch might erase my game save. And none of us want that, do we? So I'm sure months from now, after this video has been made, that will not be an issue anymore. Just explaining myself for the moment. Is that another windstorm creeping up on us? It's difficult to pinpoint the direction that it's going to hail from. Now that we have our little rover, I would like to create a seat, but I'm out of compound. I think I'm gonna get killed. Unless I can hop in this middle compartment. Give me the habitat right now before the boxes start flying. I think I got in just in time. And while I'm in here, I want to give you a little tip. When I tried to record at first, I was only getting 22 or so frames per second, which was quite low. I restarted my entire computer, and when I logged back in, I was getting over 50 frames per second. Perhaps a memory leak? I don't know. Either way, just a little bit of handy advice. If you're getting really bad frame rates after playing on your computer all day, give it a little restart to try and see if that helps. I feel a bit fascinated by the green sunset on this tundra planet because the sun doesn't just go down, it goes over to the side. It's been beyond the horizon for like a good minute now, but it's not quite dark yet. I mean, it's dark over here, but you can still see the glare of green in this direction. But what it means when we have a longer sunset and sunrise is that it's longer until the solar panel opens, which means wind power is going to be way more important on this planet. And also in that distance is, look at that giant solar panel. Some kind of satellite crashed over there. Absolutely going to check that out. But first, before we do, I'm going to spend two more resin, create a new platform because we desperately need a printer. And I've got the copper necessary from one of our storage bins. That printer is going to let me turn that lithium that we've been saving up slowly into a big battery. And I'm hoping that big battery resets the smelter over here. Elsewise, I'm going to have to make a second smelter because of some weird bug in the game. As far as I know, I'm not doing anything wrong with it. So let's find out. We got the solar panel, storage, turbine, drill head. I'll be back for you. Remind me. Battery's good, and we still got one lithium left over. If we ever find an extra fourth, I can make another big boy battery. And do we have any open pods for said battery? As of right now, no, because I'm using this one for a storage bin. I do need one more resin, and I can create the fourth directional pod hub. But I don't see any over here that we can use. It's going to have to make a run back to the ship here in just a moment. So how about we just set this down next to our faithful printer here, because this is a good spot to put it into anyway, and move the battery into position. So the wind picks back up, it will continue juicing. However, it's strange that this is juicing, but hold on, idea. Aha, maybe I have figured out how to fix our little problem. At least if the battery fills up, I can move the battery over on top of the smelter and get it to work that way, even if it is a bit roundabout. Do you think we have enough resin now? I went back and fetched this other storage unit, which came with 8 more resin on it. I used 3 for these little hub platforms, and I've got 2 more if I want to turn these into a full-fledged platform, which I think I would like to do here. Not sure what I want to use it for just yet, but we're making kind of a clock face, more or less. All of the platforms are going around, and I'm not sure if we'll have any room to drill some more tubes between them if I want to. I'll have to think about that in the future, but for now, I'm pretty happy with our expansion. And I'm kind of getting sidetracked. Let's take a look at the battery here and see if we can finally crack the case of the missing smelter. We should have enough power for this now. So I'm going to move the battery back and try using the smelter and see if it regenerates or not. Now, I made the rover before I realized that I could jerry-rig the smelter into making me some aluminum. So really, all I want from you now is a truck. I'm sorry, Rover, I didn't mean to do this to you, but I'm gonna take one compound. Actually, I need a second one. Luckily, we can reach from all the way over here, because the only way to move this car is to create the seat and drive it away. Kind of wasting some compound in the process, unfortunately. But oh well. I was serious earlier, by the way. Serious about finally getting the crane. You'll see. Right, let's park the Rover over here. To be forgotten potentially forever. Switch on over to the truck, and we've got 3 smelted aluminum here on the smelter, and one more hanging out in the storage from a long time ago, perhaps. And let us have truck number 2. And I can't remember what the crane costs. It might require aluminum, might require copper. I'm about to find out. As it slowly builds up, gotta wait on that power to regenerate. Gotta fill up the truck first. And it just so happens, poking around in our very first cave, that I've also found our very first coal deposit up on the ceiling in this tundra cave. Brand new stuff. Might make the generator valuable to us. And if not that, then at least I can trade it, right? And sell it for some other resources that we might need. I'm sure it's got to be worth something, because this is literally the first deposit of coal that I have come across. And I'm low on power because we don't have any tethers stretching back to meet us here. And there are spike plants everywhere. Just like on all the other foreign planets. They've always got to have their own dangers, don't they? I've carved a path of destruction in my wake to get through them all. These pink broccoli trees of death. The crane needs copper. You know what else needs copper? Generator. So if I waste it on the generator, then we won't be able to make the crane, so we'll have to wait to test out the coal later. So how about for now, we just drop it on one of our storage containers? That is a very spiky ball. I don't know why I like the way that looks. I also saw a winch. Titanium. Finally, a use for titanium besides making little capacitors for oxygen. All right, Crane. You know what? I've got some malachite. I've got some copper ore ready to be smelted. And unfortunately, this is going to insist upon being busted. What a strange bug. After screwing around with everything one more time, I move the battery over and we got our smelted copper. Got two already ready and waiting for the crane. Now for the moment we've really all been waiting for. Put the crane on the back. We still got no driver's seat though. I could probably just move this driver's seat off and over to save our compound. Sometimes I'm wrong. You can't. So instead I'll just take two more compound. We have been storing it up for a reason and create a single seat. I'm willing to expend the resources. This looks exactly like the vehicle bay, actually. Except we're gonna be the ones controlling it. And now for the drill head. Two more copper. Well, I've got one copper. Are you sure I don't have one extra copper just laying around somewhere waiting to be used? I don't? Okay, well, we'll have to set out with what we've got, come back and upgrade it with the drill head later. I'm still pretty excited. Just for the simple sake of having the crane. And before we go, let's say we take our handy dandy solar panel with us along for the ride. The big boy solar panel. I know it's only going to be effective while the sun is out, and we had a discussion about that earlier, but I think it's a little bit more reliable at least than the wind vane. So where should we start? And what are we even going to do with this crane without a drill head? Possibly nothing. So before we go any further, let's check it out and see how to activate it. It's got its own seat. We can hit tab to extend the arm. And as I move the mouse around, it follows where I am looking. This is as far as we can extend, all the way across. Left clicking does nothing. Right clicking does nothing. What's it good for? I think we need the drill head. You know, if we can't find any more copper just yet for the drill head, we may as well do something useful. Like inspect the giant solar satellite over here. Or, and whatever this zebra-colored marble is, which has my attention first, admittedly. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to roll over you. I want to treat you with respect. You're the first of your kind that I've ever found. It doesn't say research, does it? It just lets me pick it up. It's clearly some kind of light source. What can I do with it? I can put it right there. I don't know why, what, or how, but I'm gonna keep it. I wish that that was some super ultra rare resource that nobody can get. I'm the first one in the whole game that's found it. But anyway, over the hill. We'll see if there's anything useful here as I roll the vehicle for an 18th time and swim through the crust of the earth. I'm drowning. Oh, that was dangerous looking, but we're more or less okay. Now, this is definitely research. It even says as much. This, however, is just a regular old crummy panel. And maybe, like in the space shuttles before, there could be loot on this thing besides just a little thing of research, which reminds me, we don't even have a research bench yet, do we? No, we don't. It's got little tubes, and it wants me to believe that one day... Okay, why is this pit here? Did I create this? I guess I did. One day, we might be able to build one of these ourselves. Which would be awesome, but I like that it's thematically consistent at the very least. It gives me hope for the future, so I guess it is just kind of a point of interest to go investigate, unless I'm really missing something here. Somehow we did it, gang. I found a cave fairly close to home base, and just close enough for me not to have to tether whatsoever is this supply of copper. Just went back up to get a fresh supply of oxygen, as I said, but power, unfortunately, is where we are short. So I'm gonna take a little look-see around and see if there's any power buried in the walls for me to borrow to make this go a little bit faster. I see none. You know, I see a little behind some poison seeds, so I'm gonna leave them alone. There's some aluminum behind me as well, that lovely shade of red. Let's grab what we came here for, though. The aluminum can wait until later. I'm sure there will be other opportunities, and I would like to get a fourth. Even numbers are good, aren't they? But I don't think we have any space for it. I've been getting a little bit of coal as well. It looks like nothing's there because it's so dark in this area. Oh, come on. I know you can get me that fourth. Wonderful. Let's go home and make the drill head at long last. My promise has not been forgotten. Doing some stunts on the way there. I can't help it. Gotta hit that big air and freak the truck out of it. Don't break the game, Etalyx. Not yet. There will be plenty of opportunity to break it later, I assure you. We've already partially broken it, though, haven't we? It's for whatever reason, this smelter still doesn't work. Well, at least we're getting some energy back here in the old truck. Now we gather the fresh copper and return, running back to the printer. And let's check out the drill head. Finally! I guess I only needed one, didn't I? Might have overdone it a little bit, but that's okay. No, I'm not gonna open the pack because I wanna watch this. We've waited so long for it to exist, and now it finally does. I'm pretty pumped. I'm pretty psyched. This is gonna make gathering resources so much easier, I hope. Let's move the coal over here so we get all the coal on one little platform, and we can probably trade all this in the future. How much does the trade platform cost instead of research? Trade is 2 aluminum. We've got 1 aluminum just hanging out over here. If I would have just picked 1 unit while we were just down there, I could have made the trade platform and traded all of this coal away, which would have been wonderful. Now let's pick up the drill head and figure out how to attach it. Okay, there was no figuring out necessary. Just have to aim in the right spot, and it's got a new chef's hat. Let's go test her out. I don't think there's really too many surface materials for us to gather. I'm not sure how difficult it is to take the truck underground. Let's just start simply. We can always get more complicated later if we want, and I can try some other areas where something besides fuel might form. Let's hop in and test it out. If we stop rolling downhill, this is completely defeating the purpose. Is this a 2-person job? Do we need a second person here to constantly keep the vehicle into position? Let's try going above the hydrazine slightly. I'm telling you, driving these vehicles is not as easy as it looks. I will try to turn to the side so as to minimize the rolling, but yet we still slide. We're just gonna rest on the thing that we're about to drill. One more go. As soon as I get in, we start rolling. Give it a little high five to the camera there. Right, left clicking. It's so fast. It just kisses the dirt and runs on what feels like infinite energy, at least while the sun is out. Can we drill the stuff that's right next to the vehicle? Look, we're spitting out the hydrazine. We've gathered up 2 slots and I've dug my own grave. So it seems. So as you drill, you automatically get the resource in... Oh no, please. No, not like this. We're gonna moonwalk back to the surface and I have a will to survive here, or my character is not going to fall into an infinite abyss and get lost forever. As we drilled the hydrazine, I noticed that what we gathered was automatically put into whatever storage we had available on the vehicle. So I'm gonna dump this solar panel and replace it with a storage, because with only 2 slots on the side of the crane, That's not enough room for everything that we're going to be harvesting from the ground. Now we have 8 slots of storage on the other side of our little cab here. And without that, any excess resources that we gather would shoot out of the side like tokens from a jackpot in the slot machine.
Ooh.
We finally found some lithium. It's not just regular old hydrazine anymore. Hiding atop this mountain is a hard rock deposit of lithium. This is the perfect test for the new drill. Except I can't seem to get the truck into a stable position. So let's whip out the old gun. I'm going to create a little curb for us here to make sure we don't roll off the back of the ledge. But why is this the perfect test for our new crane? Well, you see, these outlier materials are the only ones that we can harvest with our gun. The rest of the rock and all the resources on it are resistant to that. So the drill should be able to punch right through. And indeed it can. It makes short work of this little lithium deposit. We can go all the way kissing the outside of the edge, and underneath the surface, the lithium changes shape. It's not just those little green spiry things anymore, those spindly collections of lithium, but rather something that more closely resembles a different color compound. But it's not compound. As we drill, look at the storage container. You can see the lithium filling in as we gather each new section of the deposit. I've got a total of 5 out of that before. The most lithium we've collected at any single time before. I'm just going to keep holding the mouse button down just in case there's any more, but I think that we've gotten everything that's here. The drill is awesome. And with 2 people, this would be even cooler, because then you don't have to get out and switch back to the driver's seat and try to alternate. With 2 people, one guy can just drive around and the other one can just start shotgunning resources from the back. That is so cool. Today has been a good Astroneer day. We got the crane, we got the drill, and we got the base on this new alien planet more or less set up, even though there's a few kinks in the system. I'm very happy with our progress, but we still have things left to discover. Specifically the winch, because I have no idea what that does. I need to find more research pods and make our own research bench for that matter, so that we can verify if there's any other hidden goodies left to discover or not. And also, I'm gonna link up the cars next time around, and we're gonna break the game. So I hope you're excited about that. Thank you all so much for watching another episode of Astroneer. It may have looked a little bit shorter today, but it was about another hour of gameplay from my perspective. But I like to cut it down into more bite-sized bits for your consumption pleasure. Thank you all so much for watching. My name is Etalyx. Let me know what you think about the series and the game and what we need to do next down in the comments below. I appreciate that very much. I'll see you next time back in Astroneer.